Ennis, who scored the first goal of the night, can finish it. Brings it in, shoots. Is it in?
Yes, it
yes,
is.
Yes, it is. He scores. And the shootout victory for Ned Ellis puts it away as the Emmers come back from behind and end up winning this game in the shootout.
Ned Ellis scores the first and the last goal of this game as their snowball is being thrown in the air by the fans as they were treated to one great game here and a great effort by both teams. Rochester victorious 5-4 after overtime and a shootout.
Well, such a glorious event as it is here, only fitting that it should be finished in such dramatic fashion as the Amherst trailed it 3-1 back in the second period, came back, tied it up, and then took the lead 4-3. The Monsters then tied it up with 1/10 of a second remaining in regulation. We went through overtime into the shootout, and the Amherst are victorious in the shootout on a goal by Matt Ellis. The Amherst win the shootout 3-2 and therefore win the game 5-4. So a great affair comes to an end here tonight, and the Amherst pick up the 2 points.
Well, definitely it was great effort by both as the Rochester team, they pause for a picture after they salute the fans that came out here. Over 11,000 people walk away from entertained. They'll be talking about this game for a long time as first time in history and the highest attendance at a Rochester game in Rochester, as we have to clarify that because we broke the record in Buffalo before. But Matt Ellis coming in, you can see him here, the left shot. Looks, fakes, use the head, does the five hole, off, looks like it went off the post. Pickard looking around, watch it again here, watch the near post. Looks like it bounces off, yes it does. A little bumper pull into the back of the net for Matt Ellis. And he gets, as I said, the first and the last goal, the winning goal for the Rochester Americans.
Well, it looked like it could have been a very tough night for the Amherst again as they had the lead and only 1/10 of a second remaining with the Monsters coming back and tying it up. But they battled back and ended up pulling it out in the crunch.
They definitely did. It's a big game. It was a great game. And I don't think it could be a better fitting game for a night like tonight for the people that came out and weathered the weather and the players they did. It's still 18 degrees on the clock at 10:02 in the evening. And